The Mr. Excel podcast is brought to you by Easy Excel. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. Today's question, sent by Rahul. Rahul says, hey, now that the Office 2010 beta is out, any chance you can show us PowerPivot? I had to check with the powers that be. This is so cool, though. You're going to love this. For those of you who haven't heard, PowerPivot, it used to be called Gemini, is a free add-in that's coming with Excel 2010. It's not from the Excel team. It's from the analysis services team. It is amazing what you can do with PowerPivot. So here I am in Excel 2010. I'm going to open the PowerPivot window and say that I have some data. I'm going to get some data from a file, from a text file. All right, we'll come out here. We'll browse for that text file. And demo. Now just let's take a quick look over here. So this is 58 meg. It's 1.8 million records. All right, so it's going to take a little bit of time for Excel to figure out what's going on here. First of all, store ID, date, division, great. Yeah, let's see. We'll have this import. I'll come back. I'll tell you how long it took. All right. Okay, that was 68 seconds. Success, 1,812,888 rows transferred. Click close. All right, so you have this worksheet here called Demo. Looks like a worksheet, right? I can filter it. I can scroll it. Check this out. There's record 200,000, record 400,000, record 600,000, record 1.3 million, record 1.5 million. Look at this. I'm scrolling, I'm sorting, I'm filtering through 1.8 million rows in Excel. And that's not it. If you have enough memory, you can put 100 million records in this thing. All right? That's not the half of it. I'm going to come back to Excel. I'm going to copy this data. This is Excel data. We'll go back to the PowerPivot window. And I'm going to paste from clipboard to new table. We'll call this store data. Click OK. All right. So now, check this out. I have two worksheets, let's call them. One called Demo with 1.8 million records, one called store data, and I want to do an analysis between the two of these. So what would you do? Do VLOOKUPs, use Easy Excel, don't have to do either of those. I'm going to create a pivot table, single pivot table, new worksheet. All right, check out this new pivot table field list. There are fields from both sheets. How the heck is that going to work? All right, so I want to see revenue by store name. Oh, relationship may be needed. Click Create, takes a look at the data because I have store ID in both, figured it out, got it right, click Close. All right, and now I have data from Sheet 1 and Sheet 2. I didn't build a VLOOKUP. It figured out what to do and created that data. This is 1.8 million records, pivot table in Excel, joining data from two different sheets. Is this the greatest thing you've ever seen? Check out the new slicers. These are new in Excel 2010, so I can build slicers vertical. There's a list of regions. Maybe a mall developer is slicers horizontal. I can choose. I just want to see things that are at Simon Malls or something like that. Simon Property Group. All right, so these are the states that have Simon Malls where we have stores. Those are the sales by those stores, and I could keep going on and on and on and on. This is PowerPivot. It's a free add-in that's going to come with Excel 2010. In my opinion, this is the greatest thing that I've seen come out of Microsoft in 15 years. And the amazing thing, it's free. The analysis services team is providing this knowing that some percentage of us Excel people who start using PowerPivot will want to get a SharePoint service that way we can publish this. But for most of us, we're just thrilled. 1.8 million rows, two different worksheets. This is incredible. So Rahul, thanks for that request. Hopefully, for those of you who watch this, you'll be just drooling. Can't wait to get a copy of Excel 2010 to give this a try. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.